Welcome to Jung Tuition. I'm Jung. Let's continue discussing basic issues in climate research since 1860. Just I uploaded my talk on climates, I saw a new video by Sabine Hassenfelder entitled, How Do We Know Climate Change is Caused by Humans? One of my viewers kindly suggested I make a simple and quick response to her talk. Here it is. Are you ready? Not for climates, but to like, to share, and to subscribe, as well as keep your little bell activated. Let's go and have fun. From the title she used, I thought Sabine might have mentioned Klaus Hasselmann, who is not hassle-free, as I had discussed in depth last September. To my astonishment, it turned out that she did not mention that crazy oceanographer at all, who shared the 2021 Nobel Prize in Physics with Manabe for his inferential statistical method to prove that global warming are caused by humans. That's strange. Instead, Dr. Hasselmann had decided to Google the answer by others. She might have used the same method for producing her recent talks on climate change. Then she also asked her team to use ChatGPT to find the required information. She seems very disappointed, for she failed to find explanation for how do we know it's us who are responsible. Obviously, Sabine's team had their biased expectation in their mind even before their Googling began, apart from their ignorance about Klaus Hasselmann's stochastic climate model. If Sabine were familiar with Hasselmann, who is not hassle-free, she might have run into my talk on this subject last year. And she might have been delighted to know her chosen claim, that is, humans are responsible for global warming, can be statistically confirmed by using Hasselmann's fingerprint method. Finally, her team managed to list five superficial reasons for her talk. One, CO2 absorption spectra is known. However, the first IR spectra her team selected has nothing to do with the three characteristic CO2 absorption bands as shown here. Besides, the second infrared spectra used is displayed in logarithmic scale with transition probability varying in over five orders of their magnitudes. If you have watched my related talks, you would have known the transition probability near 800 per centimeter is almost 1 million times weaker than that of the central CO2 absorption peak called Q branch. Why did you choose this diagram that could mislead the public and the illiterate politicians? Two, we know atmospheric CO2 level has been increasing. Indeed, it's true. But are you aware, Dr. Hasselmann, that the so-called climate sensitivity is an adjustable parameter on demand used in all computer models? And so there is no justification from the first principle. Three, the ocean acidification, come on, Dr. Hasselmann. This research field is beyond your background in particle physics. No point to simply hearsay. Four, carbon isotope ratios. She simply quoted others' claim that carbon atoms in the atmosphere might come from fossil fuel, mainly. It seems quite amusing that she could accept anything without using her brain. I'm not a biochemistry, but I don't think plants are capable of selecting carbon-12 instead of carbon-13, just because carbon-13 has one more neutron at its nucleus. Perhaps Sabine could launch a patent called separating CO2 isotopes by cucumber. Five, stratospherical cooling, which Sabine had discussed last year. Notice she still used the same manipulated observation data published in 2016 without any new evidence. In doing so, she might have forgotten that even Manabe himself thought the stratospherical cooling could be partially caused by ozone. If possible, I would like to have a debate with Dr. Hausenberg on the related issues via Zoom. In particular, whether or not the stratospherical cooling can be justified by his theory and by observations. Her description at the moment seems just a joke.
Carbon dioxide warms the Earth's surface, but high up in the atmosphere, it actually has a cooling effect. In a layer that's called the stratosphere, the additional carbon dioxide helps the thin air shed heat more efficiently.
What were you talking about, Dr. Hausenfeld? A thin air can block infrared ray? How? How about atmospheric emission? Finally, it is necessary for viewers to know that Sabina's talks on science have been prepared by her team members who wish to take advantage of her image and background to amplify their own voices. Meanwhile, Sabina could gain more incentive from her channel. In doing so, she has acted as a businesswoman rather than a retired particle physicist. As an independent climate researcher, I would like to suggest she read hundreds of published papers and evaluate them, like I have been doing. Otherwise, her brand value would be completely depreciated eventually. But of course, I will not be surprised Dr. Hausenfeld would continue running her YouTube channel as a part-time presenter without doing her in-depth research, but merely relying on transcript provided by her business partners, because she seemed to have been obsessed by her public image somehow. Thank you for watching. Thank you for donation. See you next time.